You can see the pictures on the screen. Okay, what is the picture you can see now?
Flowers.
Yes, teacher.
Flowers. Okay, this is my mistake. I have asked you a question, yeah? I have told you, don't scream everyone. One by one, you can answer me. Children, flowers you can see. Okay, can anyone name what which flower is shown?
Yes, me.
Sunflower.
Sunflower. Okay, what is the color of this?
Yellow.
What is the color
yellow.
Of this?
Yellow.
The petals are
yellow. Okay. Yellow. Stop. The stalk and the sepals are green.
Please. Okay, please stop, children. Please, let me explain. See, children, here the flower you can see yellow color. I have told you, not only yellowish, you can see different colors of petals with the flowers. Flowers are of different colored petals. And last class I have told you, flowers can be very, maybe petals different color, sizes will be different, shapes will be different. But we are going to learn the general features of the flowers and functions of the each functions of each part of the flower. I have told you we are going to learn general appearance, that general features of the each part and the functions of each part. Here you can see parts of a flower. Here is labeled here, this part shown, short stalk. S-T-A-L-K, stalk. Don't read stalk wrong, okay? Wrong pronunciation. Correct, stalk. S-T-A-L-K, stalk. And children, I have told you, how the stalk or how, okay, what is the function of the stalk? Anyone can answer?
Me.
What is the function
me.
Of, okay, Rital, answer me. What is the function of the stalk? Rital, can you answer me? What is the function of the stalk? Come on, Rital.
Yes, teacher.
Tell me, what is the function of the stalk that you cannot see in the reader? It will not be in the reader. It is not in the reader. Can you answer? But I have explained many times in the class. What is the function of the stalk? Come on. Stalk is a stem-like structure and helps the flower to
attach the flower to the stem.
Yes, help the flower to attach with the stem. So children, everyone listen again. Listen carefully. What are the words I am talking or what is the answer I am giving now? It is not available in your reader. So listen carefully. Stalk is a stem-like structure that helps the flower to please, children, listen to me. See, very clearly I am giving you all the answers.
So, function of stems?
Stem, function of stem, I didn't ask, my dear. We are learning about parts of a flower and functions of each part. See, children, I have told you that part. It is labeled as stalk, S-T-A-L-K, stalk. And I'm saying to you again, the function of stalk is help the flower to attach with the stem. Got it? I will repeat, stalk help the flower to attach with the stem. Now, here you can see sepals. Sepals are green leaf-like structure. I will repeat the function of sepal. Sepals are green leaf-like structure. It protects flower bud. Or sepals protect flower bud. I'm repeating the function of sepals are protection. Give protection to the flower bud. Here you can see petals. Petals are most colorful part of a flower and help to attract insects. And most of the petals have pleasant smell to attract insects. I'm repeating, children. Petals are most colorful part of a flower. And we are talking about most flowers, okay? And most flowers have pleasant smelled petals to attract insects. Here you can see stamens. Stamens are, you can see here, okay? Stamens are male reproductive part of a flower and it has pollen grains. It consists of pollen grains. Stamens are many. Okay, in some flowers stamens are more, some flowers are less, but not one stamen, okay? In all flowers we can see many stamens. Here, this is the female reproductive part, is called pistil. And I have told you, the tip of the pistil is called stigma. And when we go through inside, means when we take a cross-section of a flower, we can see the different parts of pistil here. It comes this side, okay? And we know the flowers help the plants to produce fruits. So this part will turn to fruit and seed, okay? That you will learn in grade 5. This part of the flower will turn into fruits and seeds are inside. When we take a cross section of flower like this, from here to here we will take a cross section, we can see the different parts of the pistil. Okay, children, pistil consists of three more parts. This is stigma and this part is another name. And here you can see some more part, two more parts. Okay, that parts and that picture you will see in grade 5, the real picture, real flower we can see. Okay, when our school will start regularly, that means when we can come to the school, we will go to science lab and I will show you what you can see inside. Okay, I'll bring one flower and I will do cross section of the flower so you can see it. Okay, actually that is for grade 5, but if we can come, I will show it. Okay. Next one, functions of flowers. Flowers help in reproduction. So I have told you yesterday, reproduction involves two processes. One is pollination, another one is fertilization. Okay, fertilization you will learn in grade 5, but you should know the answer. Define pollination. So I am repeating that answer. The process of transfer of pollen grains from stamen to the stigma, or in your reader it is given, the process of transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another is called pollination. Children, I am repeating that answer. I want you will repeat after me, but mute your microphone and repeat, okay? The process of transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another is called pollination. Children, mute your microphone, please. I will repeat, the process of transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another is called pollination. Here you can see the picture, flowers help in reproduction. That means flowers turn into fruits and inside the fruits there are seeds. So from the seeds, new plants can grow. So we can say generally, flowers help in the process of reproduction. Reproduction means what you know it, yes? In grade 3, from grade 3 you have learned. But I will repeat, reproduction is living things. Yeah, I know, living things have the ability to produce their own babies or their own offsprings. Living things, plants also are living things. So plants also can produce its own new baby plant. That process is called reproduction. So in reproduction, in plants, flowers help in reproduction. So we can say in reproduction, two processes are involved. One is pollination and another one is fertilization. Pollination is the process. The transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another is called pollination. And the next function of flowers. Some plants store excess food in their in the flowers. So we can say flowers help in store excess food. We can say two functions of flowers. Flowers help in reproduction. Flowers help in store excess food. Okay. Here you can see the picture. Most of the flowers, sorry children. Most of the flowers, or we can say some flowers change into fruits, or we can say some flowers turn into fruits. Some flowers turn into fruits. And you, after that we have learned yesterday, flowers can be categorized into two groups. Edible flower, sorry, flowers, no children, fruits. Fruits are categorized into two groups. Edible fruits and non-edible fruits. See, edible means to be eaten. That means we can have it. We can eat it. Okay, so you can see the examples here, mango and apple. More examples you can add. Okay, children, and non-edible fruits are, children, listen very carefully, the tura and foxglove. Foxglove, these are the two examples of non-edible fruits. See, I will tell you the question. Maybe check this picture carefully, the tura, okay children? This is the picture of the fruit, the tura. D-A-T-U-R-A, the tura, okay? This picture, question can be asked in the form of identify the pictures. So you have to write the name. This is a non-edible fruit and the name of the fruit is the tura. Easily you can remember. See, it looks like the outer external appearance is like a coronavirus. So it will be easily you can identify the tura. Okay, children, external appearance means, did you understand?
Yes.
Means
yes,
it looks
yes,
like
outer. But it kind of looks like a cactus too.
It looks like external appearance of, listen to me children, external appearance of this flower is like a coronavirus. So it will be easily, you can easily memorize, okay? The tura, what is the name of the fruit children?
Tura.
The tura.
The tura.
Spelling D-A-T-U-R-A. Another one is?
D-A-T-U-R-A.
Okay, my children are very good. Can you mute your microphone? Okay, children. See, the another one is foxglove. It is, this also you can remember easily. Fox means, you know, yeah?
Yes.
It is like two words.
Yes.
Fox,
yes.
Glove. But fox, it is not fox and glove, okay? See, children, this is not two words. It is one word. Okay? After that, we have learned yesterday, fruits are, fruits protect the seeds, or we can say seeds are protected by the fruits. So we can say the function of a fruit, protect the seeds. Function of a seed, protect the seeds. Function of a fruit, protect the seeds. Function of a fruit, protects the seed.
Protect the seeds.
Okay, very good children. My children are very good. See, all are following with me. I'm so happy. Really, I am very happy. Okay, I am very glad. Because you all are listening to me very carefully. So I am very glad to see you all children. My children are very good. See, here you can see two examples of fruits with one seed. Peach and mango. Peach and mango. Okay, children. After that, we can see here, some fruits have few seeds. Example, mango and orange. If you know, you can add more examples, okay? Some fruits have many seeds. Example, kiwi and papaya. Some fruits have many seeds. You can write examples, kiwi and papaya. At least two examples you should know. Maybe the question can be asked in the form of first line, write two examples for each. Question A, I will tell you, listen carefully. First main heading will be, children, I will tell you how the question can be asked in the exam. Listen, children. Listen, let me talk. I will explain to you first. If you have a doubt, you can ask me after that. Question will be in the form of, first heading, write two examples for each. And question A, fruits with one seed. So you can write two examples, peach, mango. Question B, fruits with a few seeds, apple, orange. Question 3, fruits with, question C, okay? Fruits with a few, many seeds, kiwi, papaya. Question D,
papaya and watermelon.
Question D, two edible fruits or edible fruit. And question E, listen please. And question E, non-edible fruits. See all these questions. What are the format of questions also I have told you now. Maybe questions can be in the form of identify the given picture. Identify the picture of given fruits. Because datura and foxglove are non-edible fruits. So that two questions can be asked in the form of identify the pictures of fruits. Or it can be in the form of write two examples for each. One seed, two few seeds, many seeds and edible fruits and non-edible fruits. Sorry, and non-edible fruits. Here you can see children, some seeds grow into new plants. That means we can say seeds, from the seeds, new plants can be grown. And you can write here one more function of seeds. Seeds also store excess food prepared by the plants. Seeds also store excess food prepared by the plants. Here children, you can see this word, store excess food. Children, store excess food. These words you can use as answer for all the functions, means all parts of the plant, function of each part of the plant. You can write these words, store excess food. Why? Because, let me explain, my dear, I'll give you time, okay? Children, I am repeating this word, store excess food. These words you can write answer for the function of each part of the plant, because root can store excess food, stem can store excess food, flowers can store excess food, leaves can store excess food, fruits can store excess food, seeds can store excess food. Okay, so the question will come in the exam. Write any two functions of maybe root or stem or any part of the plant. So easily you can score one mark. How you can score one mark? You can write easily, store excess food. Each part of the plant store excess food. So each part of the plant you can write as function, store excess food. Easily you can score one mark. Score means you will get. Did you understand, my dear children?
Yes.
Sure.
Yeah.
Teacher. We understand.
Understood, yes?
Yes, understood.
Yes, see, very slowly. Very slowly I am teaching. Very, very slowly we are moving. Very slow. I feel now I am teaching like a class one children. Very, very slowly I am moving. So all should understand it. Next, children, we have some review questions. Question 1, Where are seeds present?
Inside the fruits.
Yes.
The seeds are present inside the fruit.
Very good, children. Very good, children. Very good. Okay, repeat everyone. No problem.
Inside
now
the fruit.
And repeat.
Inside
the fruit, or we can say in the fruit.
They are located inside of the fruit.
Yeah, now all of you put your microphone. You all got a chance. Now mute your microphone. My children are very good. Now mute your microphone. Next you question. No, we will not write.
Oh my
if
God.
I want you to write, I will tell you. See children, here you can see. Give any two examples. Example of fruits with one seed. You can find any example from here. Or you, if you know mango, if you learned already mango and peach, okay, no problem. You can write mango and peach. Here, fruits with many seeds. You can write any two examples, okay? Here, we are moving to summary of the lesson. Summary of lesson means what we have learned in this lesson. Very fast, you can see. Two main parts of a plant, root system and shoot system. Parts, root system consists of only roots. And the root system consists of stem, leaf, flower, fruit, and you can, you know now, functions of root, stem, leaf, flower, fruit, and seeds. At least two functions you have to learn. See, very easily I have told you, you can write for each part, you can write as function, stores extra food. So easy for you. Stores extra food. Store excess food. Okay, children, that's all about our lesson. Now I will share another screen. Are you able to see?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Teacher.
Now, okay, I will call one by one. Okay. First, I will call one by one. Do you want I will read the first or you can read it? One by
we
one.
Can you can read it.
Yeah,
we
very can. Good. Okay. Okay,
we
then if you want, I will call all of you. Mute your microphone. I will give you chance to everyone. If you will mute, my work will be easy. You all will get a chance. Or if you will unmute, I have to call every time. Come on, mute. Like that, I will waste my time. So children, I want Fatia Ramadani.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, Fatia, can you see the screen?
Yes.
Read now. Fatia, read. No, properly. Roots help trees to remain firmly fixed to the ground. That is the answer. Here you can see more options. Release water, remain firmly fixed, move and release starch. That from that you have to find only one answer. Remain firmly fixed. Okay, Fatima, what is your name? One more time.
Fatia.
Okay, Fatia, read question two. Fatia, read question two. Yeah.
Water.
Roots
and
yeah.
Soil.
Come on, children. Yeah. Roots absorb water and minerals from the soil. Okay, Fatia, read again. Roots absorb water and minerals from the soil. Come on, my dear.
Absorb water and minerals from the soil.
Okay, again. Roots absorb water and minerals from the soil. Okay, Fatia, mute your microphone. I will call another one.
Teacher, I can.
I know. Those who are asking are very smart. I want those who are not asking. Maybe they will sit like that. They will feel lazy to read, so they will not tell me. Okay, Yasin Sama. Yasin Sama.
Yes, sure.
Okay, Yasin, read question three.
Okay. The system, the
Yes, team.
I told you yesterday. Wait. My dear, wait. Please wait. Don't say steam. Stem. Stem. Steam is another word. S-T-E-A-M. Steam. That I will teach you afterwards. Okay? Now you have to know the word stem. S-T-E-M. Stem. Not steam. Steam is another word, my dear. And another meaning. Okay? Repeat again. Come on, read. Hello?
Me, teacher, me.
Okay, wait. Who was reading?
I want to... Yasin was reading, but I want to read.
1 minute, wait. Yasin, where are you, Yasin?
Can I...
Yasin? Where are you, Yasin?
I am here.
Okay, read, Yasin. Are you able to see?
Yes.
Are you able to see?
Yes.
Then read. Okay, read.
The stem is the main part of the root system.
Root system?
Root.
No, root, no, shoot.
Shoot system.
Yeah, shoot system. I will repeat that question one more time. Everyone listen. The stem is the main part of the shoot system. Shoot, not root, okay? Root system consists only roots. Here, shoot, S-H-O-O-T, T, S-H-O-O-T, shoot system. Okay, here you can see more options, root, shoot, plant, water. But answer is only shoot. S-H-O-O-T, shoot system. Okay, question 4.
Read, teacher, read.
Teacher, want to read. Teacher, please.
Okay, what is your name? Tell me.
Rital.
Okay, Rital, read.
Number what?
Number 4. Number 4.
Okay, the underground part of stem, which is used by some plants to store food, is called tuber root stem bud.
Okay, what is the answer?
Tuber.
Okay, very good, Rital. Okay, very good, Rital. Mute your
microphone.
Okay, read. Okay, read. Number 5, read, my dear. Not Rital, another one. Another child.
Mango, cherry, ginger.
What is the answer?
Ginger chilen.
Okay, very good. Ginger. Okay, now I will explain one more time. Ginger stores excess food in the stem. Okay, children, bell rang. I have to wind up this session. Okay, Sunday we will meet again. Sunday be ready with the
teacher. I can make you so much.
You love me? I too love you.
I miss you.
Okay, even
bye, teacher.
Okay, bye, children. We will meet again.